Hello there, and welcome back to another Thunders Productions tutorial. I'm the madman behind the mic, Jag Thunder, and this is Minecraft. And what's up, guys, and welcome back to another fun and cool tutorial. All right, guys, so this is what we are going to be building in this tutorial, the USS Freedom, one of the newer United States ships, the LCS-1, and there over there is LCS-2, and I'll have a separate tutorial on that. This one is on the USS Freedom. So a quick flyabout, get a real good look at it. We got a hangar bay. There is no interior to speak of, just where the little boats are on the side. We've got the doors that are kind of halfway open back here. After the tutorial, you can go ahead and rip those out and close up the sides of the ship if you want. So down here where the boats are, there is a small bit of interior, just some walls around the outside, and that is it. So it will be up to you to put an interior in it. I'm using stained glass for the windows, and you can change that out for whatever you want. The main materials we're going to be using is going to be light gray wool, black wool, and red wool. Some dark gray here on the front, some red. We got some cobblestone walls, some anvils. We got some quartz blocks, some cobblestone walls up here, another brick. I've got some solar panels up here. You can use whatever you want when we get further in the tutorial. And that is pretty much it. Got a little bit of, again, textures pack specific blocks right here, sponge. You can just use black and yellow blocks to make that piece. And that is pretty much it. Ladder, trap doors, some buttons, and we are good to go. All right, let's fly over here. Let's get a few dimensions on this thing. All right, dimensions are 23 wide, and that is at the furthest extreme point to the furthest extreme point, which is right here on this cobblestone wall to the other side of the other cobblestone wall. It is 119 long. Again, that is from the extreme point above waterline to the extreme point, and that would be the trapdoors on the very end. And it is 38 high, again, from the very bottom all the way to the tip top up there at the top of the mast. The water level is 4 high, and I will go over this again later in the tutorial. So it's going to be underwater by 4, just so the black line is showing. All right, here is the funky colored one. This makes the tutorial so much easier when I can separate it into very common pieces, just like this here. I can get you to build over half the ship really, really quickly. But anyways, we're going to have a middle section, a front section, and then an aft section. You guys are going to start with this front section piece. And you're also going to build this piece right here that's going to be attached to it. And I am going to switch over texture packs so that you can count this a lot easier. All right, real quick, I flipped over to default. I try to remember to do this, guys, whenever possible. But this is what it will look like in the default texture pack for you, those of you that just run in the default. All right, let me switch to my other pack. All right, guys, so this is what we're going to be building right here in the middle. This is my other M4K pack. You can get the souped-up version in the description below. This is my personal tutorial pack. You can use whatever color here that you want, and you don't have to use the whole thing solid. You can just do the first row, these colors, and then do in the middle light gray, black stripe, and then red on the bottom. And then same thing on the far end. You can just do one stripe, just so you know where this thing stops and starts, but it is 68 blocks long. So you got 68 blocks long, and the width on it is 15, and it is a square. So you got 14 layers up to here. It just makes it all square. It's a rectangle. So anyways, you've got your rectangle here, which is 14 high, and then you've got right here at the black line, you can go ahead and make that solid across the middle. That's going to give you your middle deck. And then on the top, you're going to overhang by 1. And then on the inside, don't worry about this pattern right now, but if you want to go ahead and put that in, you can just pause the video right here. Don't worry about the trap doors. It just didn't cover copy over. But anyways, you'll get another look at this later on in the tutorial. But if you want to go ahead and do that, that way you know where everything matches up. And then there's a stripe right there for the hangar bay. Don't worry about the stairs. They're just randomly placed. It is non-critical. All right, so that is your layers 1 through 11. All right, after you build that, connect it to the front on the center line, which should be right about here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 on each side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Come out by 1. So right here is going to be your first block of this guy right here. This thing right here. You're going to have on the bottom 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. It says 20, Jag. I did label things for a reason. Anyway, so you got 20 blocks from that block here coming out from the orange down your center line. Then you're going to go up by 1 and 3, two, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 diagonal, and then 2 on top, just like that. And then if you want to pull back a line of dark gray, which is actually 31, 32 counting the front white one, you can. Again, later on, we will go ahead and put that in. So again, that part's non-critical. Just get this piece right here. And again, I would suggest at least doing this part out of white. The rest you can switch over to your gray as we build. It will just keep things a lot easier as we're building along. And then your back pieces are just going to be your starter points right here. When we get to the back, we're just going to start on the orange right here. You're going to grab your red, and then you're just going to start building off the back like that when we get to this point over here. All right, guys, let's find a super cool place on the map right over here. Looks really good. And let's sit back, relax, grab a handful of nuts, kick yourself in the face, and let's get this shit rolling. All right, guys, so this is what you should have. You should have that middle rectangle piece done and your colors on the end if you wanted to. If not, no big deal. It should be fine as you build along. So this is where we're going to start. I'm going to start facing on the left side, facing forward, like I always do. What I do on one side, guys, you will do on the other. All right, so we're going to start here with these first two blocks, and we're going to put two. And then we're going to come out by three, one, two, three. And then we're going to come out by three, one, two, three. And then we're going to go two, and then three. And then there should be five left over. One, two, three, four, and five. And it should connect in just to the inside of this one right here. That's why I cut it off right there, because it's nice and straight. All right, fill this in solid. Do the same thing on the other side. All right, guys, there's layer one is done. We're having fun. Let's continue on. Go behind this white block right here by two. And we're just going to kind of stay to the outside by two and keep going back. Three sets of three. One, two, and three. And this is going to overlap right there. And then we're going to go four. One, two, three, four should overlap by two, and then we should end up with three. One, two, three, and it should connect in to your orange piece right there. Again, do the exact same thing on the other side. All right, guys, layer three. We're going to start right here behind these two blocks, and we're going to go back by three. One, two, three. We're going to have two sets of two. One, two. And then we're going to have two sets of three. One, two, three. One, two, three. Just like that, we're going to have a set of four. One, two, three, four should connect right there. Come out by one and go back six, two, three, four, five, and six. And it should connect into the side just like that. All right, guys, that layer is done. Easy squeezy, lemon peasy. Let's continue on with level four. We're going to start right here behind this one. We're going to drop two blocks, and then we're going to go three. One, two, three, and we're going to do two sets of two. One, two, just like that. We're going to do a set of three. One, two, three. And we're going to do it one more time. One, two, three. And then we're going to go out by 10. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. And it should connect in just like that. That is your last red layer. All right, above the water line, guys, we are on the black layer. We're going to start right here behind this block. And we're going to put down by one. And then we're going to come out by one, two. And then we're going to have three. One, two, three. We're going to have two sets of two. One, two, just like that. We're going to have a three, one, two, three, and then we're going to have 13. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and 13. All right, black layer is finished. Starting your first light gray layer, come behind this gray block, or that white block, just like that. Put 1, and then go 2, and then go 3, 1, 2, 3, and do another set of 3, and then do 2, and then do, whoops, let's get rid of that one, and then do another set of three. One, two, three, just on top of that, and it should be 13. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and 13. Super simple. All right, next layer, guys, is just moving up and moving back out. Everything kind of stays the same. We're just going to go 1, 2, and then another set of 2, and then a set of 4. I said kind of, right? 3, 4, and then two sets of 2. 1, 2. And then out again and go back 15. 1, 2. So we already had 13 there plus 2. Come on, guys. What is it? 15. All right. Just like that. All right. Moving forward off the white block. Go back by 2. And then go back by 1. And then go back by 2. 1, 2. And then go back by 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then 3. 1, 2, 3. And then 2. 1, 2. And then off right here again, another 15. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. All right, guys, moving on to the next layer. Let's go right here, go behind this one here by 1, and then 3 sets of 2. 1, 2, 3, just like that. And then we're going to do a set of 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then we're going to do a set of 2. 1, 2. And then we're going to do 16. So it overhangs by 1. We had 15, and that makes 16, right? That is right. Counting with Jag. All right, there you go, guys. All right, almost done. We've got two more layers. Again, starting right here and go back by one. And then we're going to do it again by one. And then we're going to do two. And then three. One, two, three. And we're going to do another set of three. One, two, three. And then a set of five. One, two, three, four, five. And then we're going to come out and we should touch right here. And it should be 16 again. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. All right, let's finish this last layer up. All right next to the white, we're going to go two and then connect up and go two. And we're going to go three, connecting up three. And we're going to keep connecting up to the ones in front of it. So there's three. We're going to do four. One, two, three, four. And we're going to do four again. One, two, three, four. And then five. One, two, three, four, five. All right. And then six. One, two, three, four, five, six. And connect up on that. And we should have 13. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, and 13. And that should start your overhang right here. Actually, that should have been my overhang. I forgot to copy that over. So it should connect in right here. That's my fault. All right, fill this section in and that section on the other side with dark gray, and I will flash a picture of the pattern for the red circle instead of wasting time in doing it. So I'm just going to copy it over. All right, guys, starting on the back. Front was super easy. Back is pretty easy too. I went ahead and put a block in for our center line, and that's just going to go back, I think, 11 on the first layer, but it doesn't matter because we're going to start right here on this inside block and go back by 4, and then we're going to go back 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Same thing on the other side. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All right, come back six blocks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And we're going to put a block in here and go by 3. And then we're going to go ahead and connect it. Go ahead and bring this up by 1 and go ahead and fill this in solid, guys. All right, one more block on the end here, guys. And then 1, 2, 3. And then 1, 2, 3. And now that bottom layer is finished. All right, guys, starting out here on the outside, we're going to go 2 and then we're going to go 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. Should stop even with this right here. All right, guys, we're going to be using a block of gold, some iron bars, and a block of iron. We're going to start with an iron bar. I'm going to put that right here at the end. And then a block of gold. And then we're going to put four pieces of iron. 1, 2, 3, 4. Should stop right there. We're going to grab our red and starting on the outside of this one right here, outside of the iron bar, we're going to go back 5, 2, 3, 4, 5. Should cover up this right here. Going to go in by 1 and then come out by 2. Should cover the gap right here. Come out by 1 and then just repeat the same thing on the other side. So we got 2 there and then 2 here and then up the side and then finish with your iron bar and your gold and your iron blocks, just like that. All right, so it should look like that so far. Really, really easy. Next layer, again, we're going to connect right here on the outside. 1, 2, 3, and then we're going to go 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then we're going to go in 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and it should cover up this right here. We're going to swing around to the inside, and we're going to go in on the fourth block. 1, 2, 3, 4, right here, and we're going to go 2, hook up on the outside. 1, 2, 3, and then go out this block here. 2, 3. Do the same thing on the other side. All right, guys, so that's what we should have so far. Last red layer, again, connecting out here on the outside. We're going to go 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And then we're going to go in by 1, 2, 3. And then connect up on the back side. Leave one open. 1, 2, 3. 4, cover up 2. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 5 connected to the back of that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then two sets of 4, leaving one on the back. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, and then one right here in the middle, and that covers up that little gap. So all you did was just trace the outside and fill it in. So again, from underneath, that's what it should look like, and do the same thing coming down the other side. A quick look at it should look exactly like the other side. Starting with your black layer, we're going to go back 15. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. We're going to go up by 1. And we're going to go out by 1 more. And then we're going to go straight across. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Same thing here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Should have 1 in the corner. And then everything in here gets filled in a solid black. All right, so it should look just like that. And we're going to start the gray layer right here. 15, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Should just cover everything up. 1, 2, 3. Now, again, I'm using stone bricks here, guys, for the doors. You can use whatever you want. Put down 2, skip 1. Same thing over here. And we're going to work our way around because the other side is just a hair different. 3, 1, and then 3. And then the door kind of tucks in behind it by 2. All right, I've got a 3-block gap. 1, 2, 3. Put down the door again. Connect to the outside. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And that is the first layer. All right, guys, the next 4 layers are exactly the same. So 1, 2, 3, 4. And we're just gonna run back 1 layer. I'm gonna show you that one. Just run this to the corner. Overhang by 1. And then you should just have 4 on each side of the door. 1, 2, 3, 4. And we're gonna build that up by 4. And your door. And then later on, you can carve this out for the anvils, but it's only 2, 3, 4 high, and then go, actually it's 5 high, excuse me, 2 here, and then 2 here, and then I've got cut off for anvils here, 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 and here, and then on this side, just go ahead and make this 4, again, holding up by 1 right here, and then swing around to this side, and you're just gonna build your inner door up by 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, and then build this up, overhang by 1. So again, you've got 4, 4, and then 4. And this is gonna go across the top, just like that. Continue that over, not over there, right here. And it should connect in right there and build this up until it covers. And do the same thing on the other side, and those 4 layers are finished. All right, next layer is really, really easy. Just grab this and trace the outside, just like this. Out by 1, right here, not over there, along the back. And once you get this done, you can fill everything in with your dark gray, and then I will snap a quick picture up of the deck markings. On the outside of this, you're going to put your trap doors 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, right to there, and then just wrap it around the outside. And of course, I'm not going to do them all, but you get the point. Just like that. And again, I will snap a picture up right here of the deck. I'm going to transfer it over, and then this part will be done. All right, guys, we're going to kind of do this a little wacky. We're going to build the sides of the ship, and then probably across the front, and then across the middle, and then zigzag in between. Just follow along. You should be fine. All right, right here where you left your line, and hopefully the line should still be there. If not, it's going to be behind your deck marking on the second one. Again, right here. And you're going to leave 2, 3, 4, just like that. And again, I'm just using that just for a visual reference. We're going to go right on top here, and we're going to go back 20. So 1. And I'm going to use blue just so you can see it, and then I'll switch it over later. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. All right, just like this, we've got 20. We're going to go back to the front. We're going to come up by 1, and we're going to run this back 19 and stop that right here. And again, you're going to do the same thing on the other side. Come back here to the front. We're going to leave 2 blocks exposed, and then put 1, and then bring this back. And we're going to make the side door right here. So we're just going to step back by 1, 2, 3, and then the opening is 9 wide. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Come back by 1, and then come out by 1, and then run everything back to the end, just to the trap doors. Again, which should have been on the 12th block right here. And then you're just going to step back by 1 on each layer. So go ahead and bring this back, step back by 1, and then bring this back and step it back by 1, just like that. All right, guys, back to the front. We're gonna go in this time, right here, back to the inside of the ship, and we're gonna go up and in by 1 right here. And we're gonna go back 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then we're just gonna step back by 1, whoops, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So on the outside, it should look just like this. And then we're gonna add 3 on top of that. All right, you're gonna take this and you're gonna run it all the way back to here. Hold in by 1 off the back side right here. So it'll be 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And go ahead and connect that, and you should have a solid wall when you're finished. All right, guys, so this is what you should have. I'm gonna do a really slow flyover just so you can see it. And count blocks if you need to. Again, hold in by 1 down here and do the exact same thing on the other side. Just mirror it, really, really simple. All right, we're gonna fly down. We're gonna go right here. And on the 5th block, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We're gonna go 1 and then 1, 2. All right, on this bottom one here, we're gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then in by 1. And then we're gonna come out by 2 and then 1, and then wrap this around just like that and put a door in on the 3rd block. So right here, grab some dark gray and put a floor in right here. So from underneath, you'll see that. If you want to fill that in, you can. If not, it's up to you, whatever you want to do. And then I put a gun station right here. Really, really simple. It doesn't matter. You can come in by two, build it up by two. Two pieces of cobblestone wall, and then on the outside I just put some little tripwire hooks up here at the top, and then put some fence gate here on the back, and you can decorate the however you want. And then do the same thing on the other side, cover this up with pressure plates again just for trim, and that's what the side should look like. All right, swinging around to the front again, we're gonna start right in here. Again, we've got our four blocks that we laid out earlier. Hopefully you're doing the same thing, guys. It makes it so much easier. Obviously you can do all this in light gray, but a little far in the tutorial now. If you did it in blue, you got a lot of changing out to do. Anyways, come in by two, go up by diagonal by one, go in by two, and then do another set of two, and then do three across. One, two, three, and again, this should be the middle. And obviously do the same thing going down the other side. Two, one, and then a two, just like that. I'm gonna start building up the front. All right, guys, next layer, we're just gonna go up by one, and then we're gonna go back by one right here. And then we're gonna go one, two, and then one. And we're just tracing the inside just like that. Really, really simple. Same thing on the other side. All right, just like that. Next layer going up, we're just gonna come in by one. And then we're gonna come in by one here on the side. And again, we're just filling in the gaps behind here. Two, two, one, and then one should fill in right here. Again, just tracing to the inside. Really, really simple design here. Two, one, and one. All right, next layer going up. Gonna come in by one. And again, just trace the inside. One, two, two, one. Just like that. And one, two, two, and then one. All right, this last one should be the fifth one. So you should go up two, one, two, three. And on this third block, just behind it, instead of going one, we're gonna go three. So we're just gonna double up this wall right here. So we've got three, and then two. And actually, we're gonna go back by one and fill in the gaps, just like that. Sorry about that, guys. Trying to figure out what I had here. And then one, two, three, and then three diagonal. One, two, and three. Again, just like this. So facing from the front, there's a really nice shot of it. And we're gonna grab our black stained glass and we're gonna start filling in the front. Dark gray actually will go in right here, and you can fill that in as far back as you want to. So like right across here will be fine for now. Underneath your door actually would probably be a little bit better. So you should have another door on the other side. I don't have mine built yet, and I'm not going to. Again, just for the sake of the tutorial, you have a door right there going out to the other side. And then you can fill this in solid. Grab your black stained glass or whatever color that you want to use, and you're just going to put three across just like this. All right, I'm going to fill in just a little bit behind because this is what my glass is going to set on. All right, there we go. I've got that filled in. All right, let's go back to our black stained glass again, or whatever you're using. You're going to have two pieces here, and then one, two, and then one, two, three, four. Same thing on the other side. Two, one, one, one. Two, three, four. All right, this is easy. You're just gonna go up by one on each side and then come in and then just trace the inside of what you just did. So again here, and just coming back in by one. One, two, three, just like that. So there is your bridge. All right, let's go ahead and cover that up. So starting right here. All right, on top of the glass, we're gonna go one and then go here. One, and then we're gonna do the inside by two, so you're leaving two pieces exposed right here. And then we're gonna turn and go here by two. And then we're gonna one, two, three, and then trace to the inside again. Super, super easy here, guys. Cover up there, and then diagonal just like that. So that is what the front should look like so far. All right, guys, starting on the top here, we got two more layers going up for right now. We're gonna count in by three, and yes, that is probably birds that you hear. I have my window open, it's hot in here, and I needed some fresh air. Fresh air freak. So anyway, you're gonna count one, two, three on the fourth block right there. You're gonna put one, and you're gonna run this all the way back, and I'm just looking on my other one right now. You're gonna overhang by one. So just go ahead and grab that and run this back, and overhang by one, and God, I don't wanna shut the window. I hope that's not annoying, guys. And we're gonna overhang by one, just like that. All right, we're gonna count in one, two, three, four, five on the sixth block. One, two, three, four, five, six. Go up by one, and then run this forward. And you should stop one short. All right, so then on the other side, again, I'm not gonna build it, but I'm just gonna build where it will stop. So it should stop just like that. All right, is what we're going to do is we're going to start building to the inside. So we're just going to go diagonal, just like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then 7. This should turn into 3, and it should be right in front of that, and it is. And then go back diagonal on the other side. And then take your dark gray, and you're going to fill in behind here to make another deck. All right, just like that. Again, go back to your light gray wool. I'm using blue, guys. Stay to the inside. 3 across here. All right, so that is what the front should look like. And of course, down the other side, I'm going to fill that in, and then we're going to fill across the back. All right, guys, across the back, this is where we should be at right now. We should have 1, 2, 3, and we're just going to connect this in right here. And then we're going to make the wall 7, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and then a white one right here. And now we're just going to build this all the way up to right here. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And whoops. And that should be a white stripe going all the way up. So grab it back to your white and run that up. And then fill this in solid. All right, just like that, and you should have 3 doors on the back. I'm not sure why they've got 3 doors, but every picture that I look at has 3 doors, and then you just put a button on each side, just like that. All right, we're gonna count up 3, 1, 2, 3, and then we're gonna go over 1, 2, 3, just like that. And then you're gonna take your black glass or whatever you used on the front, just so it looks good. And I'm grabbing another brick slab. In my other texture pack, this is black. So you can use cobblestone and that works just fine too. All right, back over here on this side, we're gonna build the hangar bay. And really simple, just go ahead and fill this up and then connect this across. And it should connect in obviously right there. And we're gonna make that 2 wide. All right, and the inside we're gonna drop back by 2. And take this across and connect in right there is fine. All right, go ahead and fill in across the top here. And this kind of simulates your door right here, and then bring this out by 1. So it looks like this is kind of rolling up, and then I've got buttons across the front, just like that. All right, let's drop in here and build the hangar bay. All right, guys, just the inside, we're gonna go 4 high, 1, 2, 3, 4, and we're gonna go back 9, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. We're gonna leave a spot for a door right here, and then we're gonna put 1, 2, and then we're gonna go across here just like this. And that's where your mysterious stairs will go. 1, 2, 3, 4, cut down, put in some stairs, super simple. That's just where I have mine. Build it up by 4, and then put your door in. And I leave my doors 3 high, just like that, on my ships, and then grab some quartz slabs, and I put the knee knockers in, just like this. So it looks just like that, really cool. All right, and then just build this up by 4, and the rest of it for right now, we're gonna build it up higher. We're just getting everything kind of laid in here. And I'm completely out of order for the way I was going to do this, but this is actually working out better than I had planned. All right, so right there, just like that. All right, looking left right here, we're gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and this is where your door is going to be, just like that. That goes across. And again, fill that in solid. And just like this. And this should come in by 1. Right there, and build that up by 2, and then build this up. And I'm using cobblestone wall again here and here, and then put your roof on. And you don't have to fill up way back there. You can just fill just up over this little piece, but it just makes it easier for right now. And let me drop back down inside. All right, so from inside, there is your hangar bay. All right, go through your door and turn left. All right, on the second block, we're gonna grab some quartz stairs or whatever you wanna use, 1, 2, and 3, and then grab some dark gray wool, and it should end up, whoops, right underneath here. And you're gonna fill this in solid, and this is your watchtower or your control tower for your helipad, right there. All right, and then just bring this across just like this, and we are at the top of the stairs. Of course we are. Let's go back to the bottom of the stairs. We're going to cover this up by 1, just like that. And we're going to fill this in. Makes things so much easier. Sure it does. And then go across here by 1, 2, and then that should be 3. Make another little doorway right here, or a little passageway. Again, the interior shit, guys. Nothing major. You can do whatever you want in here. I don't have mine tricked out anyway, so this is all I have. I just have like a little chair sitting here, kind of gay, but whatever. All right, turn and go right. And we're going to build a little door around here. So go up two and then come across and fill that in solid. Again, if you want to fill this in solid, just like that, it's wasted space. There's nothing you're going to be able to do about it. And then, whoops, make this too wide. Did I? Okay. And one more across the top, just like that. And one right here. And then again, you're going to have a step right here up to the next layer. And that's going to be right here. And we're just going to run this back for right now to right here. All right, if you wanted to switch this over, and I'm just going to go ahead and switch right now to a light gray, just to kind of put your wall in right here. Should look just like that. And I think I've got 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And this moves in by 2. And then here gets filled in and then wraps around the back. And I've got a window overlooking the hangar bay, one block in, and then I put in 3 just like this. So again, it's just overlooking the hangar bay. And you can put clear glass. All right, and then this deck here just gets filled in across here. However you want to do this and figure out your decking for where you want different things. Again, this is probably, let's see, light gray going across there, something like that. Again, whatever. You're going to see a little bit of it, but it's fine. And then you're going to take this all the way to the front. All right, all the way to the front. I did screw up. This is going to actually drop down by 1. I meant to set just the glass on top of it, and I got a little carried away, and I put the floor in too damn high. So what you're going to have is, and I'm just going to take out just enough so we can see what's going on here with the inside floor, is, let's see, just like that. You're just going to come in right here instead. You're just going to drop everything by 1, and that will connect in back to where we just were. Oops. Right back there. So now this will come in right here. And then you have another little floor down here that is 3 high. All right, the little boat section. So go ahead and put this in. And then this will come across here. And you can put a step here on each side. Again. Oops, whatever. Something like that shit. I'm on the inside. You guys can figure this out. This is really easy right here. Just put a deck in, go all the way back, put a stair in, and go up to the gun mount. All right, let's go ahead and build the boat real quick. All right, we're going with some quartz slabs. And make it easier, I'm going to face this way. We're going to come in 2 blocks. On the 3rd block right here, we're going to go in by 2, and then actually by 3, and go 2, 3, and 4.
Yeah, I don't know why the fuck that just don't look right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Do I have 9 in the opening? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
All right, my opening is off by 1. My opening is off by 1. Make sure that it is 9 wide and you're opening on the outside. I don't know what I did. Anyways, back to your slabs. Really, really simple boat here, guys. It's not really, really fancy. We're just going to trace the outside. We're going to double it up. And then we're going to go across the back. We're going to do the same thing. Just like this, and it's going to be 3 wide.
And the middle, just like that. And then 4. And if you guys can come up with something better, go right ahead. I'm just going to come in by 2 on each side. And then 1 right here for the front.
All right, and then on the inside, I have like a little crane type thing that lifts this up and swings it out. I don't really know. Again, I haven't been on this. And the videos that I watched wasn't really, really specific about what was right here, or at least I did not see it. And I'm just putting this in just so I can see where that's at. All right, so again, you can put a crane in of some sort that comes across here and then down. And so, I mean, something's got to swing this boat out. So you can have like a railing, some kind of a rail system that takes it out and extends. And like this would, you know, stick out and then drop the boat down. Again, I'm not really sure. You can come up with something a little bit better right there. And then we're just going to have a door on the outside and enough room to walk. And put a door right here.
And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And actually, I stayed tight to the boat because there's no sense walking around it.
And then this space over here just stays open. Is this another? Oh, this is not another door. Sorry, guys. Go ahead and close this off. This is not another door. I don't think there's another boat bay on this side, so that will be solid. And that is pretty much your interior. Really, really easy. Really, really simple. Yeah, that looks good. And then don't forget your gun station right there. All right, let's put on the top, and we will be finished. All right, I have everything switched over to the gray now, and we're going to go right here above the top. We're going to come in by two, and then we're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, and 19. All right, we're going to spin and go to the inside by 1, and then we're going to go one more time and go 6, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And obviously, you're going to do the same thing over here. So if you just come straight across to right there, that wall is going to be right here. Going to come in by 1, and then 6. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, back over here. Connect on the back side, go 2, and then just go diagonal the rest of the way. Oops, should be right here. One more should be center. And then again, in by 2. Connect it on the back, and then go and go diagonal. And that should look just like this. All right, now we're gonna do it just like we did the front. We're gonna go up 2, 3, right here. And then just go back by 1, 2, 3, and then 2. So 1, 2, 3. All right, so looking at this layer from the front, 1, 2. And on this block here, this turns into 2. And you're going to have another set of 2 right off the back here. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So it should stop right here. And, of course, do the same thing on the other side. All right, go back up here to this little top block. This little top brick, I said blick, I think, and make it 3 wide, just like that, and then come back by 1 on each side, 1 back on each side, and then 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So again, right here, 1, 2, 2, 3, 4, 5, and it should stop right here. All right, that's wrong. Sorry, guys, got just a little bit ahead of myself. All right, so from the side, you're going to see 1, 2, and then 1. And then 2 more here in the opening, and then go 8. And now somebody's shooting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, just like that. And then this one right here underneath just goes, I'm gonna have to shut the window here in just a second, guys, sorry about that. And then overhang by 1. Fucking assholes. All right, guys, so you should have this much of the top piece done. We're gonna take some dark gray wool, and we're gonna go right down in here, and we're gonna put a secondary deck. And right here, and this is where your radar equipment is going to go. And I'm going to show you that at the end of the tutorial. We'll trim that out. So just go ahead and fill this in. Again, I'm only going to do just the one side so you can see what I'm doing. So it should look just like that. Same thing over there. All right, swing around back here. And right in this little slot, we're going to fill... you bastard. Fill this in right there. All right, switch back over to your light gray wool. And we'll continue the side going back. Go in by 1 right here, and then run this across, and it should connect in right there.
Is that fucking right? Why does that not fucking look right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That should only be fucking 7, and that is like fucking 100.
All right, guys, slight adjustment. I don't know what the hell I was thinking. Again, I'm getting toward the end. Getting a little frustrated with the fucking neighbor. I'm going to be like, just go ahead and cut that out. I don't know. I probably got some splicing right there of me cussing really bad. But anyways, put 2 just like this. And then you're going to build up behind that. Should be 5. So you're just going to come back here by 1. And then up 2, 3, 4, 5. Just like this. She should have a little step and it should end. So you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 pieces of gray. All right, now go to the inside.
With your gray, 3 pieces, and then come across the back, right here, and I'm going to get rid of this, and it should be 2, and then here, 1, and then here. Does that look right? No, that don't look right. There we go, right here. And we're going to come in by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There we go. Now it's looking right. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 behind it, just like that.
All right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then in the corners, right here. And then fill that top in solid. All right, just like that, same thing on the other side. Another fly around just so you can see and count blocks, stop where you need to. Just like that. I know I was a little crazy there on the last few parts. All right, we're going back to our light gray, and we're going to be going right here. 1, 2, 3, right on this deck right here. We're going to be leaving these two, and we're going to go right on top the gray, and we're going to go back by two, hook up by two, and then come out 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And this is what I was trying to do earlier down here. I was just totally looking at the wrong one. So again, connect here, and then 2, 3, 4, 5. In by one, and then one right here. All right, and you can just fill this in solid if you want. It doesn't matter, because we're just gonna build on top of it anyways. And then right here, again, come in by two, go 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then one on the back, and then fill that in solid. And then again, 1, 2, 3, and 4, two on each side. So this is the beginning part of your mast. All right, again, 1, 2, 3, just like this, and then 1, 2, 3, and then one going off the back, and then one here, and one here. So it should look something like this. All right, now we're just going to go right down the middle. 1, 2, 3, 4, put two here, and then hang off the back by one. And then we're going to go 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then two. And the same thing on this side.
Oops, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, is that right? I think that's right.
All right, and then we'll go look at the mast when we're all finished, and I'll show you how to trim that out, but that is the main part of it. All right, down here on the back, all right, we're going to make two little boxes on each side, and we're going to count in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and I'm going to go ahead and switch over to the light gray wool so I don't get confused no more. We're going to have a three block center, 1, 2, 3, so just like that, and then just bring this down.
Oops, dark gray, guys, dark gray. Dark gray wool down the center. This is the top deck. Just like that. Bring this all the way back to right here for right now.
All right, so we're going to stop it right here for right now. I think it stops one short, but we're going to go right back here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then bring this in. And you're going to do the same thing over here, just like that. So you're going to make two little pockets. All right, and then in and down, we're going to go ahead and put in some walls. And this is going to be light gray. Hold in by one.
And you're going to do the same thing here and come across. And this should connect in right about here somewhere. And we need to hold in by one, I said. All right, just like that. So this kind of sets in, and then go ahead and put a floor underneath it. And it should set right on top here. And again, you can go a little bit further if you want. We just need a floor, something that we can see from at the top. Just go ahead and fill this in. And of course, you're gonna do the exact same thing in the other opening. Pretty simple, just like that.
Balls and gravy. All right, on the outside, we're gonna cut two holes right here even. So one here and a hole right here. And then on the inside of that, we're gonna put two pieces of iron block, just like this. All right, and then you can take your dark gray or your light gray wool, doesn't matter, and just make six pieces behind that. Again, if you wanna switch this material out, you can, doesn't matter. And then on top of this here, I have daylight sensors, and I'm not gonna grab them, so whatever. Anyways, we got one row right here.
Fucking mouse, you fucking suck. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. All right, and then this should go 8.
From right here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And then right down the middle. And it should be 5 wide total. So you're just going the 3 wide. And you're grabbing one from the outside, making this 8. So counting this block, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And I am one heavy. I figured I would be. All right, and you're just going to make that 3. And we're just going to change this last little layer out because this is going to make a wall. We're going to go underneath that by 5. One on each side will make 7. And then we're just going to double that up one more time underneath that. And then straight across from here, we're going to come in 2. Straight across here, come in 2. So that it lines up with these two right here. And then we're going to bring this across with your light gray. It's just like this. And what this is doing is creating a door right here. And I can just go ahead and fill this in. You're not going to see any of this once we put the floor in. And then you've got a door right here. And then same thing on this side. You've got a door right there. And you can go ahead and fill that in behind there if you want to. Again, you're not going to see it. And then take your dark gray and fill this floor in. All right, so it looks just like that. All right, go back to your light gray, and 2, 3, 4, 5. Leave a two block gap right here. There's gonna be a ladder that is gonna go right in here. So put a little Another piece right here, so you can climb the ladder and step off on that and then get up to here and then bring this across. Oops, just like that, covering up the white. All right, and we're just about finished. We're going to put these top package guns on. All right, and those are going to go right here on the outside. And again, I'm using another brick. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and then turn. And so it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then turn again. It's going to go right here in this opening that we made. One on each side, and then across the front. And then you can fill that in with solid gray. And then 9 bricks in the back. Bricks, blocks, whatever. One coming out like this. And then 3 cobblestone walls. 1, 2, and 3. And again, you're going to put the same one over here, and then that'll have that. And then we've got one more gun position down here. And again, we're using the nether brick. And we're going to start right here next to the stairs. That little opening that we just put in, we're going to go 1, 2, and then we're going to turn 1, 2, 3, and then we're going to turn just like that. So it should be 3 wide across the back. All right, grab 2 quartz blocks, and I'm just going to use wool for right now and go right out of the middle just like this. And then go back to your nether brick, your stairs, and just put a couple in like that and then come back at it just like this. So it looks like it connects into the side.
And then this one here, you can actually turn that around. There we go, just like that. Is that right? Yeah, these go to the outside. Sorry, guys, I got those turned the wrong way. And then these go across the back like this. And you can actually turn those in right there. And then the next piece right here.
And then just put a trap door on the top block on the outside. And that is pretty much it for the USS Freedom. Let's fly over here and we're going to look at the top decks and then this forward gun position too. You'll have some iron bars around the front right here, so just follow the outside front on the outside gray pieces. We've got some anvils that you can just kind of throw randomly wherever you want. We've got another big gun here in the front, so find center, which should be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 each way, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then you're just going to put a 1, 2, 3, 4 block piece right up the middle. So right here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, there you go, so you can see that. And then off of this, you're going to go 3, 3, and then 3, and then hang 2 off the back, and then go back in and connect right here, and then come out by 2, and then 1 here, and leave an opening right here in the middle, and that's where your cobblestone wall will go. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 pieces of cobblestone wall, but the one is tucked in right back there. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and that is your forward main gun. Really simple on that one. And again, this is what I have for the guns. MC Edit does not like to flip things around, but that's there. All right, on the upper decks, this is what I have for like radars and shit. And I've got a lot of it covered up with your carpet. So you can go through and you know, kind of figure out. I'm not sure why I did that. I think, after the fact, I think is why I covered mine up, because it was all light gray instead of doing it dark gray like I did the tutorial. But if you have any spots that you want to cover up, obviously you can, and then pressure plates around the outside would look pretty cool. Just a little quartz block with some another brick fencing here and here, and then just repeated that on the other side. A little cobblestone wall, a couple pieces of gray wool, and then a fence piece. This little thing here is a cobblestone wall, 2 blocks, and then 2 slabs on the outside. Really, really simple radar piece here and here on the other side. Up here on the main tower, go out 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 pieces of cobblestone wall on each side. And then on the very top, we've got 2 more pieces. And then we've got 1, 2, 3, 4 more pieces of cobblestone wall coming out between that. And then 1, 2, 3, 4 more pieces of nether brick fence on top of that. And then a little cobblestone wall and some slabs, and a solid block here in the middle. Some nether brick fencing around the outside, a couple pieces up the back, 3. And then down here, got some more satellite radar type things. Again, 3 or 4 pieces, another little radar piece here. And then we've got some stacks of some sort here, and I'm not exactly sure what these are here, guys, but those are easy, 1, 2, 3 by 1, 2, 3. So again, you can just turn your nether brick stairs all to the inside and then put a piece of black in the middle. And in 1.9 we can put a trap door down in there along with dual wielding. Awesome. You can tell I'm excited. Anyways, we've got our daylight sensors on top here for your missile launch stations. I can't remember exactly what those are called right now, Got a little radar dish back here. You can outline your gun in red. And this should be, I believe, the your SeaWiz cannon. And again, there I've got floating trap doors. And then just some random trap doors here. Some other brick fencing. This is just all just random details. Some buttons across here. There's your ladder, black and yellow across the middle here. Some random spots on the side for like ventilation on the inside. So just underneath these iron pieces, put some buttons on. You can go down four and then put a group of four, skip two and then put two, and then two over here, and then six up just like that. And it's exactly the same on the other side. Again, it's some sort of ventilation, probably for a birthing area, I would assume, but I'm not really sure. And then on the inside, underneath the glass, I've got mine trimmed out with black. And there's my wall just behind the glass. So again, just some ideas for you. There you go, for the bridge. And that is pretty much it. I got some stairs here going down. And that is all that I have done on the USS Freedom, guys. Anyways, I hope you really, really enjoyed this tutorial. It was fun. It was really, really simple design. I moved pretty quickly through it because it is fairly, fairly easy. And I hope you guys had a great time with it. Make sure you hit that thumbs up button for me. I really, really appreciate it. Like always, remember to rate, comment, subscribe. Follow me on Twitter, and I'll catch you guys on the next one. Later.